Since I would like this video to be monetized and people to actually see it, I can't say the word right now, but I am a big fan of the phrase, F around and find out. Who remembers or knows the story of the browser previously known as Iceweasel, later going by GNU Icecat? Well, this name originally came about as Mozilla back in the early 2000s was very touchy about the use of their trademark, the name, the logo, the branding. Unless distributions use the binary files supplied by Mozilla, fall within the stated guidelines, or else have special permission, they must compile the Firefox source with a compile time option that creates binaries without the official branding of Firefox and related artwork. Now, Debian back then basically got on the bad side of Mozilla with some of the modifications they were making, and pretty much were forced to rebrand the entire Mozilla suite, and they decided to go with an ice motif. Now, by 2017, this long-standing trademark issue had been resolved, and Debian nowadays is actually shipping the regular Mozilla suite. But the reason why I bring up this old story is for a good reason, because history, unless you learn from it, tends to repeat itself. Not with Mozilla this time, but instead with Fedora and OBS. About 3 weeks ago, this issue was opened on the Fedora Flatpak repo, broken OBS Studio Flatpak presented as official package. The unofficial OBS Studio Flatpak, that being the Fedora Flatpak version of OBS, is seemingly poorly packaged and broken, leading to users complaining upstream, thinking they are being served the official package. There are several examples of this being the case outside of OBS Studio as well, and many users who are unhappy with Fedora Flatpak being pushed with no or unclear options to opt out. Linking to this issue in GNOME software opened by Jordan Petridis, prioritize verified apps over non-verified apps in sources list, and this one over on Fedora. Deprioritize Fedora Flatpaks and prioritize FlatHub in GNOME software. I made a video on this back when this was made, and I pretty much agree with the fact that yes, FlatHub probably should be at the front. Just get rid of Fedora Flatpaks. And hey, it seems like some of the developers here agree. We would like to request that this package is either removed or made clear that it is a third-party package. It should not be upstream's responsibility to ensure downstream packages are working, especially when they overwrite official packages, that being the official OBS Flatpak available on FlatHub. I would also like some sort of explanation on why someone thought it was a good idea to take a Flatpak that was working perfectly fine, break it, and publish it at a higher priority to our official builds. We spend an enormous amount of effort on our official Flatpak published to FlatHub to ensure everything is working as well as it can be. Thanks in advance. Now, this segment here is what we refer to as F around. Now let's go to the find out segment. Now, to the best of my knowledge, nobody is talking about this yet. Maybe something comes out between the recording and the release of this, but there's no Pharonix article, nothing like that. But oh, I'm sure someone is going to talk about this. As of 11 hours ago, as of the recording, another reply from Joel Beth. Since it's clear that Fedora does not have any interest in a rational discussion at this point and has decided to resort to name-calling, we are now considering the Fedora Flatpak's distribution of OBS a hostile fork. This is a formal request to remove all of our branding, including, but not limited to, our name, our logo, any additional IP belonging to the OBS project, from your distribution. Failure to comply may result in further legal action taken. We expect a response within the next 7 business days, by Friday, February 21st, 2025. Thank you. Now, you might notice the singular like here. This is by Hari Rana, who you may know better online as the Evil Skeleton, who you may know also better as a frequent contributor to the Bottles project. Now, this is not to say that Bottles is also going to get involved as well, but the project is for sure aware of OBS doing this, and Bottles has bounced around the idea of doing the same. Now, I'm not going to say the name of the person who shared this with me. I don't know if he wants to be directly involved. All I'll say is he is a very active OBS contributor. Now, what he had to say is Fedora effed up so badly, they managed to make OBS act. It's frustrating, and nobody in the OBS community wanted to make use of trademarks against another free software community. I understand that completely. Entirely. Like, this is basically a last resort you go to after nobody is taking the problem seriously. This is what you do when you're saying, okay, this is the nuclear option. We are going to deal with this. I don't care what your opinion is anymore. This is going to be fixed. It's one thing if there's a broken package, like the one provided in the Arch Linux repos. I've talked about this before. Do not install OBS in the Arch repos. It's always been broken. It's always going to be broken because the maintainers do not want to fix it. No matter how many times it's brought up, they refuse to fix the dependencies. Things like browser docs don't work, which breaks a ton of other features. Now, that's the thing that they could easily fix. The thing they can't fix is because it's an unofficial version, it doesn't have the API keys OBS has to have the proper streaming platform integration. Breaking things like, oh, I want to log into my YouTube account and have everything just automatically appear, have my browser docs appear, which obviously wouldn't work because of the other stuff missing, but with it there, you can just log into YouTube, log into Twitch, log into Restream, never have to deal with the stream key, and you just click live, everything just works. But the difference is when you install it from the Arch repos, you install it with Pacman. This is a very clearly different thing than the official Flatpak available on FlatHub, because you install it with Pacman, which is a different command to installing it with Flatpak. It's very clear you're getting a different thing. In the case of the Fedora Flatpak versus the official Flatpak from the OBS project, you install it with Flatpak, or you install it with GNOME software, and you're installing a Flatpak. So most people installing Flatpak are going to assume it comes from FlatHub, because frankly, FlatHub is the only place, with the exception of like beta repos and things like that, where people are installing Flatpaks from. It is a reasonable assumption to make. Now, if you look around the UI, you can see, oh, it's coming from Fedora Flatpak instead of FlatHub, but users are reasonably going to make the assumption that it's a Flatpak, it's from FlatHub. So if they go looking for where to get the official version of OBS, oh, I install a Flatpak, I get the official version, but they're actually not getting the official version, they're getting this third-party package from Fedora Flatpaks instead of FlatHub. So, if a user has an issue, where are they going to go with the issue? Well, they're not going to go to Fedora Flatpak because they don't think they have a Fedora Flatpak. They're going to go to the upstream project because they're installing the upstream package, at least they thought they were, so they get these issue reports that they can't fix because they didn't cause a problem, like this one here, or issue reports that are just related to not using the official package. If you had the official package, this problem wouldn't exist, but they keep getting these issue reports from people who think they are using the official package when they have no idea they're not. And yeah, it's annoying to deal with users like this, but I'm not blaming the user whatsoever. They are just making a reasonable assumption based on the thing that they thought they were doing. It's the distro that is entirely at fault here. When this keeps happening over and over and over again with no signs of things changing and no one listening to the argument you're making, I can understand why this would get frustrating. And I don't like that this has had to happen, but I really hope that Fedora actually sorts out what they're doing before other packages have to resort to doing this. Enough is enough, Fedora. Fedora Flatpaks is a failed experiment. If you want to keep doing this for unofficial packages, sure, whatever, nobody cares. But you cannot do this when a project provides an official package any longer. I don't just mean with OBS, I mean with Bottles as well with the repo package, and anybody else that takes issue with this. Now, thankfully, the maintainer of the Fedora flat pack is smart enough and doesn't want to deal with a lawsuit. So there has been an update to the package very, very shortly after this was posted, like five, six hours later, something like that. End of life. The Fedora Flatpak build of OBS Studio may have limited functionality compared to other sources. No, objectively does have limited functionality. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Please do not report bugs to the OBS Studio project about this build. Now, I also hope that there is some private discussions happening dealing with this right here, because yes, doing this is important. They would much rather the project just be entirely deleted. However, going EOL and then deleting it later is at least a good start. Just make sure OBS knows about it so they don't further pursue this. I know there are people in Fedora who argue downstream packaging provides a lot of value, and in some cases, I'm sure it does. But when you're providing a measurably, objectively inferior product and then passing off the issue tracking to the upstream, no. No. Just stop doing it. But what do you guys think? This might be the end of this saga. I really hope this is the beginning of a change in Fedora and they just stop messing with upstreams. Just stop it. But what do you think? Let me know your thoughts down below. So if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out our Patreon, Scribes, and Liberapay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I like OBS. I really do. Like this.